Yeah, my name's Sam Weston. I am a DevOps engineer for a company called Pulse Live. We build websites and apps for some big sports organizations, football clubs, Premier League, kind of big sports organizations you've probably heard of. So yeah, I'm just going to talk about when you've got this new shiny K3S cluster you spun up with Sivo Cloud, how on earth do you then monitor it, make sure it's working in the way you expect? It can obviously be a problem that's quite daunting because there's so many moving parts with Kubernetes. How do you know that you've got all the right monitors in place to monitor every aspect until that particular thing breaks for you and then you know to add it? So the cheat that I've got basically is something called Prometheus Operator. So that's something that CoreOS developed quite a while back, and it's basically a way to configure Prometheus with YAML. So rather than having one big config file, for example, to configure your monitoring, you can deploy your monitors or your alerting, everything alongside your application. So I've got some examples basically that I can go over. And yeah. So I'm assuming here you've already got a Sivo cluster and you've already got all that run up and running and your kubectl command is installed and working. So again, I've cheated because we're a bit short on time. I've already deployed all this stuff, but I'll show you all the commands that I ran to deploy it. So now, yeah, and I've also posted all the resources on GitHub, which we'll link around after this is finished. So you can go and copy and paste basically what I've done so you can run it on your own cluster. So yeah, so I'm gonna run a Helm deploy, which of course isn't there because I just copy my README file from my GitHub repository, that's the easiest thing. So to install, it's just a simple Helm install. So go and install Helm 3. Again, the link's on the GitHub repository. The values file I'll go over now while that's running. So the default values that come with it are great because they have a lot of monitors installed, a lot of alerts and everything that you'll need for most Kubernetes clusters. I think they cover pretty much everything that you're going to want in production. There's a few things I've had to turn off because it doesn't quite work with K3S. For example, etcd, the version of K3S that we're using in Sivo, I don't think has etcd. It uses a different backend for storage. And Kube Controller Manager and Kube Scheduler don't work, I believe, because K3S is one binary, whereas traditional Kubernetes has got a whole load of different services to run. So I've just turned those off in my Helm values file. In this case, I'm sending all my alert manager alerts to an SMTP server called MailHog, which is a really great testing tool actually for just receiving. It's a dummy SMTP server with a web UI. So you can see here, I've had one alert go to it that I've just had a test alert basically. It's a dummy SMTP server, which you can run in your development environment. So you don't have to set up hooking into Gmail or Office 365 or whatever your actual email server is. I've got some commented out bits here, which is what you do if you wanted to hook it into Gmail. You can also, at work, we use Slack. So we have it send Slack messages using a Slack bot token. I've also sent a few alerts which come with it to the null receiver, which means that they won't go to my email inbox. They'll instead just basically be muted. You might choose to mute different things. These are things which in my cluster I don't care about that much, so I just don't want to get alerts for them. And yeah, here are my receivers. So I've got a null one and an email one, which is youremail@gmail.com. So you'd probably set that to something different. I've also got inhibit rules. So one great thing about Prometheus and Alert Manager is that you can have the same alert with the same name, but you can tag it differently. So if I have the same alert with the same name tagged warning with one set of parameters, and I can have a different alert that's critical with a, say, a higher error rate or a higher latency, so things are slower. So you can have two levels. So maybe have two Slack rooms or two email inboxes, one for your warning alerts, which are kind of things are a bit bad, and one for critical where the big guns get involved for those critical alerts. So that's really useful. I've also set a persistent volume for Alert Manager. I've upgraded Prometheus, but generally speaking, the default settings in here are pretty good. You'll also see there's a lot of commented out bits, which are more kind of things you might want to set if you're running it in production. So Kubernetes resource limits and requests. The one big thing with Kubernetes that trips people up when they first use it is they don't set their, especially requests. Limits are important, but requests are really important. So you end up with Kubernetes scheduling pods that need 5 gig of RAM or something like this one does on a node that doesn't have that much, because you haven't told Kubernetes that you need that much RAM. So your cluster, it's especially important with K3S, because you can run pods on that master node. And if your master node falls over, you're in big trouble. So yeah, when you're running this in your environment, definitely look at uncommenting that and working out, I'll show you some dashboards that can help you do this actually. Work out how much RAM you need and set these CPU requests, especially, and RAM requests, because you can get yourself in big trouble. So that's basically the values file. It's more or less, you can go into GitHub and look at the official Helm chart with the default values, and they're pretty good. So that's a good start. One caveat with this demo actually is you need to be using the development version of SIVO when you spin up your cluster. The version 1.0.0 that comes by default, for whatever reason, some of the monitors don't quite work. So I spun this cluster up that I'm using with the development version. And you also can't use it on Raspberry Pis at the moment with ARM64, because some of the Docker images in the Prometheus operator chart don't have ARM64 builds yet. But fingers crossed, it looks like ARM64 is getting a lot of traction, and that's really improving fast rate. So maybe in a couple of months, you'll be able to install it on your Raspberry Pi as well. Great. So let's go back to my terminal. My install's finished ages ago because I've spoken for ages. So that's now installed. That's installed Prometheus. It's installed Alert Manager, which the sole thing for all Alert Manager does is routes your alerts that come from Prometheus for your problems that are going on to email or to Slack or something like that. And it's also installed Grafana with a whole load of dashboards, which you'll need. So basically it's out of the box got most of what you need. So let's start with Prometheus. So let's show all alerts, all the rules, actually called Prometheus rules, but they are alerts that go to your email inbox. Most of these are green because nothing's broken, which is great. You can see there's a whole load of stuff about how much disk space is left on your volume, whether some nodes are failing, whether, you know, there's just a whole load of stuff that is things you need to monitor in production when you're running Kubernetes. I mean, pretty much in our environment at work, we are using pretty much all of these monitors out of the box, and we don't have to add that much because it's the community is just covered basically everything you need to monitor. And even things in your application, like if your pods in your application are crash restart looping, your daemon set rollout stuck. So even your application gets monitored to some extent with these default alerts, which is really great. So this is the Prometheus web UI. You'll see on my GitHub page, I'm running port forward here to forward Prometheus, Grafana, even MailHog to my local machine, because I haven't set up ingress. You don't get any authentication with Prometheus to start with. So the easiest thing to do is not expose it to the internet. You can stick things like Google OAuth in front of it with third-party tools. You can stick basic authentication on top of it, which is a really easy thing to do using Trafic, which is the ingress that comes with K3S. But for the purpose of this demo, let's just do port forwarding because it's the simple option. This is the Prometheus web UI. You won't really use this that much. You can see the rules and what's failing. Let's turn that off. And I can just see the watchdog is, I'll get into the watchdog in a bit, but that always alerts. And then I've got one container that apparently is having a lot of CPU throttling, so that's only a warning, that's not a pending alert, sorry, so it's not actually going to fire an email yet because it needs to have that problem for a bit longer to get the email. So yeah, Alert Manager, not very exciting. Probably not going to look at that web UI a great deal, but the great thing is Grafana. So all these dashboards except two, which I'll go over in a second, are included out of the box. So you get, you know, API server metrics, go back, there we go. You get cluster compute resources, so you can get a feel for how much RAM and CPU are full up on your nodes. And you can look, there's a load of stuff for compute resources. You can drill down into individual nodes or individual namespaces or individual containers and workloads. So really great stuff there. So what else have we got? We've got networking. Another caveat with K3S, so the default volumes, persistent volumes in K3S use local storage. That volume driver does not export metrics in a way that this picks up. So if you want the shiny metrics, you're going to need to install things like Rook, which I think are on the Sibo marketplace. So some other slightly fancier volume thing than the persistent volume driver than the built-in local storage one. But other than that, I mean, if you go through these dashboards yourself, you'll see that pretty much all of them are there. I shouldn't pick that one, clearly. But generally speaking, the compute resources stuff is really useful. Networking, stateful sets, nodes, quite nice. I can see, again, resources on your nodes. So, great. Why haven't I gone over? yes. So, in addition to that, in my GitHub repository, again, I've applied a bunch of YAML files for traffic monitoring, because that's not going to be in every cluster, so it's not in the Helm chart, but it's really simple because it's all Kubernetes YAML with the Prometheus operator. I can just deploy service monitor YAML with just kubectl apply, which will just hook Prometheus into the Prometheus metrics port that already exists on Trafic and will already exist on loads of cloud native stuff. If you've got your own application, it's really easy to add metrics with Prometheus compatibility. So that hooks Prometheus into it so it can see metrics from your app, or in this case, Trafic. I can add Prometheus rules YAML, which is, as I said, alerts. So in this case, I'm monitoring the error rate from my test website that I'm hosting with this ingress. And I'm monitoring latency. So I said earlier, you can have warning and critical. So in this case, if my website's slower than 1 second response time for 5 minutes, it will send a warning alert. If it's over 5 seconds latency, so really, really slow, that's a critical alert. So you can do this kind of thing to monitor additional things that don't come with the chart. And it's all YAML. You just deploy it with your application's YAML files. And there's no manual fiddling around with config files. It's just all YAML. Finally, I pinched this off of Grafana's really great, I don't know what they call it, but they've got like a dashboard marketplace on Grafana's website. So you can download the JSON for those dashboards and deploy those in config maps, and Grafana will automatically pick those up. So if I go here, I've deployed that config map with that dashboard, and it just appears here in my Grafana, and I can see response times, error rates for ingress in this case. But there's dashboards for pretty much everything you'd ever want to deploy in Kubernetes. So that's the first thing. The other thing is Blackbox Exporter. So not directly related to Prometheus operator, but there's another Helm chart you can deploy for Blackbox Exporter. What that does is polls HTTP endpoints. So say you've got something outside of Kubernetes, or you want to check that the whole routing all the way from your CDN all the way down to your application is working. You can poll that HTTP endpoint and get metrics for it and do alerting on it. So in this case, I'm just polling test.cablespaghetti.dev, which is a test website I spun up. And again, I've put some Prometheus rules. In this case, the Helm chart supports Prometheus rules, so I haven't had to do YAML. I've just stuck it in my Helm values file. And again, I've deployed a dashboard, which is slightly customized from the one on Grafana's website. But again, I can see how long this probe's taking on average, milliseconds, what each stage, so how long the connect takes, how long the DNS resolution takes, all that kind of thing, how long my SSL certificate's got left. And you can do alerts using Prometheus rules on all this stuff. So it's all in your Prometheus system. So finally, what about if your Kubernetes cluster goes down and you're running your monitoring for your cluster on your cluster? So you can, I said about the watchdog alert earlier, so that always triggers. So you'll see here it's firing. You can route that wherever you like. So I can send a webhook to some third-party service. There's things on the internet that do this. I think it's a dead man switch website. That's what it's called, a dead man switch system. So, however, you can also hook it into PagerDuty if you're a PagerDuty customer. I've just spun up a simple AWS Lambda function in our environment. So this is something that we've just open sourced from PulseLive. So you can deploy that in an AWS account. It'll cost you pennies to run because it's all serverless stuff. And so this trigger will come from Prometheus, go through Alert Manager, get sent to your AWS Lambda function. And if that alert stops because your cluster's gone down or Prometheus broken in some way, You can have that separately send you a Slack notification or an email, or in this case, it's a Slack notification that it supports, but you could customize it to do whatever you want. So that's a really useful thing, because that's something that is often missed, because if your cluster goes down or you have a networking issue, suddenly all of that lovely monitoring you've configured just doesn't work anymore. So it's worth considering. So yeah, we'll link to this. There's much more detail on here than I have time to go over right now, but we'll link to this in Slack and I guess in maybe Twitter that is linked to after this. So great, that's me done.